Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're gonna be comparing two of GM's engines, the 6.6 liter L8T gas engine against the 6.6 liter Duramax L5P. The L8T gas engine was released in 2020 as the successor to the long-lived 6.0 Vortec. The 6.0 Vortec was a very reliable engine. It had a fantastic reputation, hence why it lasted so long in these HD work trucks and was known to just be a great work truck engine. But unfortunately, the 6.0 Vortec had been around for a long time and it was time for GM to upgrade the engine to help compete against some of the newer gas engines coming out, like Ford's 6.7 liter Godzilla engine. And that's how we ended up with the 6.6 liter L8T Gasser. The Duramax L5P has been around a little bit longer since 2017 as the latest and greatest Duramax diesel in GM's lineup. So in today's video, we're going to go ahead and compare the two engines. We're going to talk about everything from reliability to performance to towing capacity, fuel economy, as well as cost. And so I'm gonna go ahead and give you my opinion on these two engines in each of those respective categories. And then at the end, I'll go ahead and talk a little bit about which engine is a winner in which categories and try to help you decide which one might be the best fit for you if you're currently looking at getting an HD truck and are trying to decide between the two. Ultimately, it is going to be a trade-off of reliability, simplicity, and cost against torque, towing capacity, and fuel economy. Let's go ahead and jump into my first category here, which is reliability. Let's go ahead and start with the L5P and talk about the reliability there and some of the common problems that it has. The L5P is probably the best diesel being made right now, and I've been saying this for a few years. Without a doubt, if I were looking for a brand new diesel, the L5P would be the one that I would choose, mostly because it has proven to be the most reliable. It does, of course, have some emissions-related issues, but the emissions equipment on the L5P is a lot stronger and tends to last a lot longer and fail less frequently than it does on some of the Power Strokes and Cummins of the time right now. There are a few common problems to talk about here. The L5P has had issues with the MAP sensor, the number 4 injector, the injector connectors, the DEF heater, and the DEF pump, as well as some smaller problems with the regen cycles, with the coolant reservoir tank, as well as with the fueling system. But overall, there haven't really been any serious problems that have plagued this engine, nor anything that is catastrophic or expensive in nature to fix. There is, of course, some of the small emissions related issues, but primarily the DPF and SCR and the EGR coolers have proven to be a lot more reliable. That's not to say that you're not going to start running into issues with those once you start looking at the 250 or 300,000 mile mark, but they have proven in a lot of cases to be able to hold up to those mileage levels without running into too many problems. So it's a great engine from a reliability standpoint. Now let's talk about the L8T. The L8T is naturally aspirated. It is overall a way more simplistic engine from a structural standpoint. It doesn't have all the emissions equipment and turbochargers and problematic fueling systems that diesel engines tend to have. The L8T has been extremely reliable so far. It is a relatively new engine, and so there hasn't really been enough time for serious problems to pop up, especially once you talk about higher mileages, but there really haven't been too many things to talk about here. One of the biggest benefits to the L8T is that it does not have active or dynamic fuel management, which is the system that plagues the 5.3 liter and 6.2 liter Ecotec 3 engines, which alleviates a lot of concerns over reliability and longevity on these engines. Just to talk about a couple problems here, there has been some excessive oil consumption issues, and in a few rare cases that has led to some timing chain problems, but that is more so negligence on the owner's part of letting it get low on oil. And so ultimately you just need need to make sure that you keep it topped up on oil. Outside of that, there have been some small sensor failures. The spark plugs seem to need to be changed a little bit more frequently. But that's really all that there is to discuss from a problem standpoint on the L8T. It's been extremely reliable so far. So when we try to compare the two, the reliability of the L5P is great, but ultimately the L8T is gonna get the win in my book because it just has a lot less of the problematic systems that diesel engines have nowadays. As we look at maintenance costs, common problems, and the overall cost of ownership, I just think the L8T is gonna be significantly lower over the lifespan of it. So now let's go ahead and move into talking about performance. These engines are the same size, but obviously one is a gas engine and one is a diesel. What that means is that the diesel is just gonna produce so much more torque. From a horsepower standpoint, the two are very comparable, but the L8T pushes 464 torque, whereas the newer L5Ps are putting down over 1,000 torque. It's tough to compare these two apples to apples from a performance standpoint, just because the way that that power gets used in a diesel engine is very different than the way that it gets used in a gas engine. The L8T is a strong engine. There have been some, I would say, heavily modified versions of it that have hit like 2,000 horsepower, but I do think that they will be very strong and can sustain probably 600 plus wheel horsepower on the factory motor. They can handle tons of power and are a strong motor. They obviously just don't come with that much power from the factory, and they're naturally aspirated. So you can't just slap a tune on it and see the same types of power gains that you're gonna see out of the L5P. And so the L5P has a lot more plug and play power that's available to it. You can push the L5P to 500 to 550 wheel horsepower before you start hitting some limitations. You can get to those power levels with just a tuner, an intake, and an exhaust system. Whereas trying to add 100 wheel horsepower or more to the 6.6 gas engine is gonna require you to do a lot more expensive and sophisticated mods to it, just because it isn't forced induction from the factory. So from a performance standpoint, it is a little bit tough to compare a gas to a diesel engine, but I'm gonna go ahead and side with the diesel engine here just because it produces a lot more torque and the tunability and mod friendliness of it is just way higher than a naturally aspirated gas engine. Going alongside that, jumping into towing, this is again, gas engine, diesel engine. The diesel engine is of course gonna win from a towing standpoint. The L5P in a max configuration package, goosenecking something can tow like 36,000 pounds, whereas the L8T is capped somewhere around 17,000 pounds or so. Your towing capacity is significantly higher on the L5P. That really is only important if you're someone who's towing horse trailers or a very heavy fifth wheel. If you're talking about towing your 6 or 7,000 pound boat, you know, both of these engines are absolutely capable of that. So towing standpoint, the L5P is going to be the winner here, but that is sort of a given just because it's a diesel. And if you're considering a gas engine, I assume you don't need 36,000 pounds of towing capacity in the first place. So that takes us into fuel economy, which is where the L5P wins pretty significantly. And that is because the L8T gas engine gets really bad gas mileage. That's what happens when you have a massive 6.6 liter engine that's being used in 3/4 and full ton trucks. Talking a little bit more specifically about the numbers, the L8T is advertised at 14 miles per gallon on the highway, whereas the L5P is advertised at 24 miles per gallon on the highway. A lot of people actually do see higher fuel economy on the L8T. A lot of people actually see it averaging out close to that 14 number, whereas it's only supposed to be getting 11 or 12 in the city. But if you are towing something, especially something very heavy, it is probably more realistic to expect something like 9 miles per gallon. On the L5P, a lot of owners there are averaging 19 or even 20 plus miles per gallon combined highway and city, and even when you're towing something you can still expect to be getting 15 to maybe even 18 miles per gallon depending on the weight of that. From a fuel economy standpoint, the L5P wins significantly. That takes us into the last category, and that's just the cost of these things. The L5P is the upgrade option for a 2500 or 3500 truck, and that upgrade comes comes at about a $10,000 price point. So if you're looking at buying one of these brand new, it's an extra $10,000 to get the diesel. Even used, the diesels are going to be more expensive, but of course you can find options that are within the same price point if you're looking at something used and different mileage levels and different trims and things like that. So the cost is a big reason, especially brand new, to go with an L8T. Even though the fuel economy is a lot lower, it's going to take you a lot of time and a lot of miles to make up $10,000 worth of the price difference just via the higher fuel economy. So where does that put us between what's the better engine here? Ultimately, it's pretty tough to tell you which one's the right choice for you based on what you're trying to do with it. So I'm just going to go ahead and recap these two engines, give you the pros and cons of each, and hopefully that will be helpful for you in deciding what's the best option for what you need. Starting with the L5P, ultimately you get better towing capacity, you get better fuel economy, and ultimately better performance, in addition to good reliability, but all at a higher cost of purchasing and at a higher cost of ownership, with a little bit more hassle of owning just because of all of the quirks of modern diesel engines. And then with the L8T, we just have a good old traditional gas engine here. It doesn't have all of the fancy components that a diesel engine has, which makes it less expensive from the factory, but also less expensive and easier to keep up with from a maintenance standpoint. And it does have less potential problems than the L5P does. It just comes at the trade-off of not having all the torque that the L5P has, not having the towing capacity, and getting poor gas mileage. All right, guys, well, I hope that was helpful in you making your decision between an L8T or an L5P diesel engine. If you guys found this video helpful, please click that like button, but also subscribe to our channel. I will do a bunch more videos on the L8T, and we do have a huge library of content on the L5P covering things like problems and reliability and performance upgrade guides. As the L8T continues to develop and get a lot more aftermarket support, I'll continue to produce more videos on this engine. So stay tuned to our channel for all the future things that we have to come, all about good old Chevy trucks.